Okay, so this is also the second attempt to record this YouTube video so that I can explain to you the format of a first school counseling session. The student is going to come in, you say hello, you ask them how they're doing, you introduce yourself, and you thank them for coming. That's essentially all you do at the very beginning, because you have to immediately move into the beginning part of the session. Okay? You need to know that in every school counseling session, there are three parts to the session. It's the beginning part, the second part is the working part, and the third part is the closing part or the goal setting part. Okay, so again, there's three sections to every session. You're going to do a brief hello, how are you, tell them who you are and thank them for coming, and then you're going to immediately move in to the beginning part of the session. Okay, you need to immediately tell them who you are and what you do. You need to ask if they know what confidentiality means. If they don't, you explain confidentiality and you give examples, okay? You explain the exceptions of confidentiality and you give examples of the exceptions. You then have to check to see if they understand, and you have to check to see if they understand what the word confidentiality means. And you have to check to see if they understand the exceptions to confidentiality. My recommendation is that you explain what confidentiality means and you give examples of what it means to keep confidentiality. And then you check for their understanding of what confidentiality means. You do this by asking them to use their own words to tell it back to you, to tell back to you what confidentiality means. Once you're assured that they understand what confidentiality means, I then suggest explaining to them the exceptions of confidentiality. There are four, okay? You need to give examples of all four of the exceptions, and then you have to check for their understanding, and I recommend that you ask them to use their own words to explain back to you the four exceptions of confidentiality. Okay? Once you get through that, you need to explain to them what counseling is, how it works. You need to explain to them the number of times you're going to meet with them. You also need to explain to them what their role is in counseling. You need to explain to them what your role is. And you need to explain to them what counseling is not, okay? You then need to check for their understanding of that. So again, I suggest that you ask them to use their own words to explain it back to them, or to explain it back to you. Then I will briefly explain to them again that the number of sessions that you're going to work with them, and give a brief explanation of why they're there. So for example, if, you know, a couple of teachers thought that maybe they could use some extra help, or knew that they were working really hard in class, but could just use some additional one-on-one time with somebody, okay? And then you ask if they have any questions, okay? Those are all the things that have to be done in the beginning part of the first counseling session, okay? The second part of every counseling session is called the working part of the session. The purpose of the working part is for us to find out what's going on and to find out what the issue is. I suggest, especially during the first session, that you ask broad-based, open-ended questions. And I suggest that you work really hard to try to ask one question at a time. So ask one broad-based, open-ended question and then stop and let them answer, okay? I suggest that you try to use as much reflection, paraphrase, empathy, and clarification as you can. I think that students respond very well to this and sometimes are more likely to give more information when we're not asking them a lot of questions. I think the other things I would ask you to think about during the working part is, do we really understand what the issue is? Do we understand what's happening? Does the student actually understand what the issue is or that there is even an issue? Okay. Do we kind of understand what the consequences are of this issue? And we don't have to ask all of these questions, but these are some of the things that I try to at least understand. Okay? And then I'm going to eventually come to the closing part of the session, which I also think of as the goal setting part of the session. Okay? I suggest moving to the goal setting or the closing part of the session by doing a quick summary of what you guys have talked about thus far. I then suggest reminding them of the number of times that you're going to meet with them total. And then I suggest asking them if there is one big, broad goal that they would like to work on, that you guys would work towards meeting this big, broad goal over the course of the entire time that you guys are going to be working together. We call this the overarching goal, okay? And an overarching goal is a big, broad goal that cannot be met in 1 week, cannot be met in 1 session. It is something that we are striving towards and striving to achieve across the total number of times that we're going to be working with them. So an example of a broad overarching goal might be improving our math grade, or increasing the number of days that we are on green, meaning green is behavioral indicator that the student was on task, sitting in their seat, not talking to their peers when they shouldn't be, okay? So again, the overarching goal is a big, broad goal that you want to work towards across the duration of the time that you will be meeting with that student, okay? Then, after you guys have set that, and that you both agree on it, and that you both are certain what the overarching goal is, then you say, okay, now the next thing we have to do is set a session goal. Because the session goal is something that the student can do between now and the next time that they will meet with you. And the session goal has to be small, it has to be measurable, it has to be attainable, it has to be realistic and relevant to the overarching goal, and it needs to be time sensitive, meaning that you will set a deadline, so to speak, for when they are going to meet this session goal. Okay, and again, this session goal should be thought of as one step towards meeting the overarching goal. Okay, so again, the closing part of the session, we do a summary first, and then we remind them of the number of times that we have left to work with them, and we ask them if there's a big, broad goal that they would like to work on for the entire time that they will be meeting with you. You'll have to explain it and maybe even give some examples, because oftentimes they don't know what a good goal would be, which is fine because we're going to help them, okay? Then once you guys have together decided what the overarching goal is, you need to make sure that they understand the overarching goal. And then you set a session goal, which again is small, it's measurable, it's attainable, it's realistic and relevant, and it's related to the overarching goal, and it's time sensitive, okay? They need to know what the session goal is. They need to understand that the session goal is one step towards meeting the overarching goal. And finally, you need to then set a strategy or strategies for how the student is going to meet the session goal. So for example, if the overarching goal is to improve their math grade, then maybe the session goal was to turn in all math homework this week. But if that's the session goal, then what strategies are you guys going to need to set so that they can meet that session goal? Well, first they need to know what their homework is. So do they write it down every day? Where do they write it down? When do they write it down? Then they need to make sure they take their homework home with them. How are we going to make sure that happens? Then they need to actually do the homework. So what needs to happen so that they do the homework? Those are strategies, okay? You need to help them set strategies because they will not know what it means to set strategies. But again, you can help them. You can walk them through it, okay? And then, once you have your strategies, then I suggest that you ask the student to restate the overarching goal, restate the session goal, restate the strategies, okay? I would then suggest that you do a summary of the entire session, also restating the overarching goal, restating the session goal, and restating the strategies. And then at the very end, you end the session with a hope statement, something like, I hope that this goes well for you, or I hope that we meet this session goal, or I hope that this was helpful for you, any type of positive affirmation, and then you end the session.